Hello there, Dermot O'Brien here from Sparx Systems. In this webinar, we'll explore how to transform behavioral models into executable source code using Enterprise Architect's behavioral model code generation features. Using the behavioral models such as state machines, sequence diagrams, and activity diagrams, Enterprise Architect can generate usable code in the more popular code languages like C++, C#, and Java, as well as hardware description languages like VHDL, Verilog, and SystemC. There is also the option to define your own code structure using Enterprise Architect's code template framework, or even create templates for generating code for another code language. These features can be used in a variety of environments ranging from high-end applications through to embedded code for automated machines, from simple devices through to components in complex units used in the automotive, maritime, and aerospace industries. Note that these features do require the unified or ultimate edition of Enterprise Architect. We'll start with an overview of a class with underlying behavioral models and then generate code from this in a number of different code languages. What we'll cover is a look at an example and the code generated, a look at the structure from the class down, generate out the code from the model, see the correspondence from elements to actual code for activity diagrams, state machine diagrams including transitions, entry and exit, do actions, and sequence diagrams. We will then view the options available for different languages. And finally, we will look at customizing the generation using the code template language. The example diagrams that we'll be using to generate the code are available in the AA example model, which is supplied with Enterprise Architect. The particular diagrams we'll be looking at cover some fundamental functions used in the input-output of a portable audio player. The higher-end design is shown in the design package under the requirements package. For our purpose, we are focusing on the software language aspect, which is used for the implementation of this portable audio player. In this case, it is a generation to C++ of the USB interface as outlined in the design model. Note that there are also hardware language examples above this. To start off with, let's take an example of a set of classes under one language. In terms of the general structure, what is required is that the behavioral models are set under a class to basically emulate an operation. These behavioral models can be called in the same way that an operation can be called, and they can also call operations or other behavioral models. For example, a state in a state machine calling an activity diagram or a composite diagram, an action calling an activity using a call operation. In this case, we explore a simple two-class model. We can see that this has one standard UML operation, set number of bytes received, as well as a much more complex behavioral model, including several activity diagrams. Here is one we'll look at, do read serial port, state machine diagrams, a key one that we'll look at is the search internal media, and sequence diagrams. This is a more complex one. We will run over a simple example later. Let's generate this class out to code to get an overall view of what is created. We select the class IO, open the develop ribbon, and in the source code section, we use the generate option. Now with the code generated, we access this via the class. By selecting the class and pressing F12 or Control E, we see the code in the code editor and its operation structure on the left pane and the actual generated code on the right pane. The standard class operation, set number of bytes received, has some simple script defined in the code properties which we see is generated out with the code. On looking at the behavioral models under the class, we see the correspondence to the code generated as operations from the behavioral models. In this case, we have the activity diagram, do read serial port, and the code generated out from this diagram. Then we have do read USB, and the code generated out from this sequence diagram. Let's have a look at each of the three behavioral models and get an overview of what each is capable of generating. For a view of the general sequence of calls, let's have a quick look at a state machine, an activity diagram, and a sequence diagram as an interactive model, each used to generate code. We start with a state machine, search external media. On looking at the do operation, on opening the code, we see that it is calling do read serial port. On finding that action under the class, as the pseudo operation of the class, we open it and see its general layout. On coming back to the state machine, we look at the next statement and see that it is a do operation. It is calling an interaction do read USB. With a sequence diagram laying out the process. So now we see how the call sequencing in this case is laid out in the state machine search external medium. To run over the characteristics of each behavioral model type, we will start with an example of an activity diagram and then look at the state machine and a sequence diagram. For an example in which we look at the correspondence of code generated from the source activity diagrams, let's go back to the serial interface diagram, do read serial port. This code generated from the activity is clearer and simpler than the state machine. We can open the diagram, place the code editor as a split diagram so we can see both. This activity diagram covers a number of features that are used for generating code. Let's start with the create object action. This is set to create an instance of the error handler class. So let's search for that in the code. This is covered in the first line of the function doReadSerialPort. It's deriving its argument pHandler from the result property. Looking back at the code, we see the line that was generated from this. Then we have the call setLastError action, which when we look at the behavior, it is calling the operation in the error handler class called setLastError. This is referenced using the browse button. We can see that the operation is referencing the error handler class. We can also find that the operation is under the error handler class in the browser. The first activity pin is referenced in the properties under call operation action as the target pHandler, and the second is referenced as the argument arg_i_error_number. We see how each of these are referenced from their respective browse buttons. In the case of arg_i_error_numbers activities pin properties, we see that it is set with a parameter value of 0. So looking back at the code, we see what was generated from this on line 103. Now in the call create port, we have in its behavior a reference to the operation under the class IO, which we find it under the IO class. The action pin provides the parameters, that is the value LPT1. All this produces a single line of code. Now we look at the loop sequence. The entry to the loop is based on the condition bValid equals true in the control flow's constraints. The while condition is defined in the control flow's guard as bDataReader equals false. There are two activities in the loop which are generated inside the doWhile statement. Each of the activities in this part of the model covers similar behavioral definitions as we covered above, hence giving simple lines of code calling operations with parameters. This is completed with an action destroy that takes the argument pHandle from the action pin and does a check on the handle and deletes it. There is a lot more, but hopefully this gives you an overview of some key places to study as to where there are definitions and where to find the resulting code statements that are being generated. Of course, the code generated can be different depending upon the languages being used, but we will cover the code generation templates later. Now let's go back to the state machine that called the activity diagram and have a closer look at the code generated for the loop between these states. Let's get the Boolean condition statement in that guard, that is the transitions constraints, and we will do a search for that in the generated code. We see that it is in the if statement in the operation. This is deciding whether to take the transition to the read serial ports or take the transition to final. We now look at the do read USB sequence diagram that we saw was being called earlier for the state machine that we first looked at. In this case, it is a simple sequence diagram with an interaction occurrence reference to another sequence diagram. It includes two messages inside an interaction fragment. We then look at the code generated from this. It is a set of clear statements generated from each. The first message is the interaction occurrence, which is a call to the more complex setup USB interaction diagram. On double-clicking this, we see the reference model. The call to the set USB has a parameter bvalid device, which is defined under the arguments tab. We see in the code generated that it is a call to setup USB with the parameter bvalid. It then has the all combined fragment with the condition bvalid. With that condition being met, it has a message to read the port, otherwise it sets the bdata variable to false. Again, in looking at the code, we see the nice, clean and simple if-else statements with these two statements generated. Enterprise Architect's code generation supports a variety of languages, ranging from the popular C#, Java, C++, through to specific embedded code languages like System C, VHDL and the like. When starting to create a new model, ensure that you set the language for the code to be generated out. This is defined in the Settings ribbon. Under the default language for code generation, we can see a variety of languages supported. Let's set this, in this case, to C#. Now let's look at creating a simple model to show how we can generate out a quick piece of code. For this, we will start by creating a package and placing a class diagram under this package. On opening the diagram, we can use the spacebar to add a class. On viewing the class properties, we see that it is set to C# in line with what we set as the default language. Now, under the class, we can create a simple activity diagram. In this diagram, we create an initial action and a control flow to an action, then an activity final via another control flow. Now, on selecting the action, then its properties, under effects, we set a simple C# line of code for a write statement. On selecting the class and go to the ribbon, develop, source code, generate. On selecting the class and pressing F12, we see the simple code that was generated, including the write statement, in the activity operation. Just to cover a more realistic example, we have a simple action loop, which we can now generate out to code. And then on opening the code, we can clearly see how the action loop was generated as a do-while statement in the C# class. The code generated is customizable in that Enterprise Architect provides user-definable templates for the setting of your own code generation structures. The use of these can vary and can range from simple adjustments to conform to one of many industry standards like DO 178C or the ISO 26262. Through to creating your own templates for another language. Okay, so let's have a look at a standard template. So we open the code template framework and choose a specific language. As you can see, there is a wide range of languages supported, including the likes of C++, C#, and the languages for embedded code like System C, Verilog, and VHDL. Note that there is also the templates option, which allows you to set up a new set of templates for a new language. So let's look at a nice simple language, that is JavaScript. Although it is not object-oriented and not available for behavioral code generation, it is used elsewhere and gives us a nice simple starter for the concepts behind these templates. If we have a look at the class template, we see that it is calling class declaration. On opening that, we see the simple string function that would be a direct text generation and next to it a call for the class name variable. This will give a simple function and the function name output. Going back to C#, let's look at the behavioral model code generation template for an action. We see a simple set of calls based on the action types, like create and destroy, that we covered earlier. In the case of create, we have the initial lines that are setting values to the strings to work with. Then there are a series of checks and warnings on the missing parameters, etc. And finally, on line 31, we have the statement to be generated out using the values of the variables set at the start. Now, to give a broader picture on this, you see that the key individual model groups are covered in the templates. Here we have actions. We just covered one, but there are many more. Now we have a look at states and transitions. And finally, interactions. As these basically cover the same process as an action, they use the same code generation as the action templates. On looking at the help topic covering this, we see that a message invoking an operation uses the code template of an action call. A message with a lifecycle delete invokes the action destroy, and so on. In this webinar, we only covered several key options for setting up behavioral models for code generation. Each of the behavioral code models have distinctive features that are generated out to code, which if covered in specific detail would mean a very long and boring webinar. So, what is recommended when searching for details on implementing a specific element type? What is best is to scan through these example models in the AI example repository, then look at the properties and the resulting code, and then use these as a starting point to define your own model. There is also a set of Java examples of behavioral code generation under Software Engineering, Java Models with Behaviors. To give a summary of the topics covered in this webinar, we firstly looked at the structure from the class down. Then we looked at the correspondence from elements to actual code for activities, including core behaviors, state machines, including transitions and entry-exit-do, and sequence diagrams. We then looked at a range of languages supported and the option for defining modeling for specific languages. Finally, we looked at customizing the generated code using the code template framework. In this webinar, we covered the standard behavioral model code generation. There are numerous other enterprise architect features in common with this, in particular, the executable state machine code generation feature, which covers a similar usable code generation, but uses the internal simulation features of enterprise architect for testing, simulating, and debugging the processes. There is also the code generation and simulation for decision model notation, or DMN. So when looking at the model-based code generation, it's worthwhile firstly considering these other options and discerning which is most appropriate for your scenario. In conclusion, hopefully this gives you a good overview of the scope of Enterprise Architect's behavioral model code generation, how to define the element properties, as well as a guide to using this in the code template framework. For more information, see the help topics under Modeling Domains, Software Engineering, Behavioral Models.